chào. That means hello in Vietnamese. So if you guys watch my Thailand video or follow me on Instagram, you know that I visit Vietnam back in February. This is where I'm from, this is where I was born, and this is where my heart is. Every time I go back, it's a different experience and a different story to be told. Come along with me as I take you to my hometown of Vinh Long and explore local living, visit the historical capital of Hanoi, drive through the bustling city of Ho Chi Minh, sail along one of the most unforgettable and breathtaking sights in Ha Long Bay, discover the ancient city of Hoi An, and visit the beautiful beaches of Da Nang. My journey started in Vinh Long, which is where I was born and lived for a few years of my life before I came to the States. Vinh Long is located in the southern region of Vietnam along the Mekong Delta. It is known for producing lots of yummy exotic fruits as well as raising a type of fish called bassa, or better known as catfish. So the next time you guys are at the grocery store and see catfish, product of Vietnam, think of me. I'm gonna take you guys on a little ride through my hometown. We are a huge producer of many exotic fruits. I got a chance to head over to one of the fruit farms and saw how cool the setup was. So we got in our yacht and cruised over to the other side. It was pretty awesome to experience nature and all of its beauty and to really see how the fruits are grown from plant to harvest.
This is the durian flower. It comes in a bunch like this, and as it grows bigger, it becomes like this one over here. It's kind of dangerous because if it falls down on your head, you're gonna die. It gets really, really big, and it has a very distinct smell, and a lot of people, either they love it or they hate it.
This is what the durian meat looks like. You might recognize it from an Andrew Zimmerman episode where he could not eat it at all. It has a very intense and unique aroma. Some people die for it, and some would rather die than eat it.
Ăn sầu riêng ngon lắm.
This is my local fruit market. I came here just about every single day. As you can tell by now, Vinh Long is a small town and it is predominantly country living. Everything is super fresh, literally caught in our backyard and served right on the table. This is where I was born, this is where my family's from, and I still have lots of family that lives here today. So it's really nice to go back and visit them when I'm home. People here have many talents, just like this guy who made a basket out of nothing. Now that's what I call DIY. Of course, it is always a pleasure to be back and visit my relatives, learn about my family history, and dig deep in my roots and never forget where I came from. It's the kind of experience that will always keep you grounded no matter where you are. So let's get on with our next adventure. Ho Chi Minh City, here we come!
Welcome to Saigon, let me turn my mic on. Xin chào, no doubt, yo, it's time to get a hype on.
If you're ever in Ho Chi Minh, don't be surprised with the amount of cars and mopeds on the road. People drive in all sorts of directions, traffic hour is crazy, and yellow lights mean hurry up, not slow down.
Hi everyone, we're in Hanoi City.
Hanoi is so beautiful and quite different from the south. There's less commotion here and the vibe is completely different from super busy Ho Chi Minh. It was my first time there and definitely won't be my last. Everything was so different from the south, from the atmosphere to the food to the people. Extremely refreshing to change up the pace. It wasn't long before we left Hanoi for magical Ha Long Bay.
Xin chào madam, welcome emotions. Hi, welcome to Vietnam, welcome emotions.
Hi.
Vinh Long literally means descending dragon in Vietnamese, and as legends are told, once upon a time, the gods sent a family of dragons to protect the bay from invaders. As you can see, the unique shape of the 2,000 plus islands surrounding this magical city resembles the bodies of these mythical creatures. I've never seen anything this amazing in my life, and I definitely recommend you guys adding this destination to your bucket list. It's about 7:30.
So dreamy here. I hope you guys like the footage.
One of the activities on a cruise ship was to tour a little fishing village. People here actually live on a boat their entire life and never leave. They fish for food, cooked on the boats, as well as had floating markets, schools, and hospitals. It's so fascinating to see how different people lived. I mean, that's all they know, their entire existence is this body of water. One of the ways the villagers made money was to paddle tourists around their turf and showed us the magic of their home. They took us to these amazing caves and everything was just so dreamy, like a haunting scene from a romantic movie. There was a body of mist hugging the waters that early morning and you could only see as far as the raft ahead of you. I imagine Ha Long would leave this indescribable feeling, something I'd remember every time I think about this Bay of Descending Dragons.
What's going on? We are now at the Golden Sands Resort, I believe that's what it's called. We just had breakfast and it was superb. There was a whole buffet line of a mix of Asian and American cuisine. Hi mom. How are you? You could write like a man and novel lives back on track. Maybe a dreamer or a clown, but still he doesn't know. The time is ticking in his ear, the holy silence disappears. Is it right or is it wrong? Or even now, you don't know how. Hoi An is the ancient jewel of Vietnam. It is so humble, quaint, and charming with its beautiful lanterns that light the city nightly. In fact, it's famous for being quite picturesque and was a destination of an episode of The Bachelor. Da Nang was the last leg of the trip and my friend recommended that I stay at the Intercontinental. It was renowned and had all sorts of stars and awards for being a super amazing resort, so I had to check it out. The hotel is very excluded from the rest of the city and is tucked away in the mountains. You guys, this place is to die for. I felt like it was Greece meets Far East. Everything was so luxurious and detailed, you really felt like royalty as soon as you arrived. The best way to get around the resort is by buggy, so one was arranged to take us to our room and we also got a quick little tour of the amenities, which was really, really mind-blowing. There was so much detail into building this place. Alright, I have a question. Are you guys ready for the room tour of your life? It's like a one-bedroom apartment and you have plush greenery to one side and endless ocean to the other. There's mountains in between and everything is just ridiculously immaculate. Thank you.
bathroom was pretty amazing. It had a beautiful tub that looked out to the gorgeous ocean and an awesome rainforest shower. You could really lock yourself up in here for a few hours and just forget about every care in the world. After we got settled in, we went to grab lunch at this super unique restaurant that sat at the top of the resort, and there were tables outside that dangled off the cliff of the restaurant. I thought that was some pretty awesome architectural design. And when you want to swim, just take the lift through the rainforest down to the ocean, and the water's all yours. One of my favorite quotes is, "The cure for anything is salt water, sweat, tears, or the sea." You can really find Zen in the sanctuary and have the opportunity to really get to know yourself better. As we wrapped up our Vietnam trip and said goodbye to Da Nang, I really felt closer to my heritage and culture more than I've ever felt before. It's so wonderful to see the progression of this little country that has so much to offer. The spirit of the Vietnamese people is undeniable, and I'd like to think that we've come a long way since the war. Perhaps you fall in love with my country too when you visit one day. So when you do go to Vietnam, please share your experience with me. I'd love to see it through your eyes. Just tag me on Instagram at House of Color and make sure to say hi when you're browsing through. Give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more destination videos. And for more photos from this trip and others, head over to my blog at houseofcolorblog.com. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye! Thank you.